Hello friends, I am Neha and I welcome you all to our YouTube channel about technology. In this video tutorial, we'll be discussing an important topic of computer architecture, that is pipelining. Pipelining is a way of organizing the execution of multiple instructions simultaneously. It not only speeds up the execution process, but it also improves the throughput of your system. Let us proceed with the video to learn how this is done and what difficulties you may come across. Now, what is pipelining? To get an overview of pipelining, we can discuss a common example of car manufacturing plant. If we talk about the first stage of assembling a car, it is preparing the automobile chassis. Next is adding up engine to this chassis. Further, the body is added to the chassis. Next, paintwork is done and finally the car is checked before delivering. Consider that there is only one group of workers in plant and they perform stage 1, 2, 3 and 4 and deliver the car 1 after time unit T4. Next, again this group of workers start from stage 1 and go on to stage 2, 3, 4, 5 and after time unit T9 they deliver the second car. Similarly, at time unit T14 they deliver the third car and at time T19 they deliver the fourth car. Now, as we know, the process of assembling a car can be divided into 5 sub-stages. Then, according to the concept of pipelining, we can organize the assembling of multiple cars simultaneously. In this process, we will require 5 different group of workers where each group will perform a dedicated task. Like, group 1 will only be preparing the car chassis. Group 2 will only be attaching engine to this chassis. Group 3 will only be adding body to this chassis. Group 4 will only be painting the car body and group 5 will only perform the final check before delivering the car. Now, according to pipelining principle, at time T0, group 1 will prepare chassis of car 1. At time T1, group 2 will add engine to chassis of car 1 and group 1 will prepare chassis of car 2. At time T2, group 3 will add body to car 1. Group 2 will add engine to car 2 and group 1 will be preparing chassis of car 3. At time T3, group 4 will paint the body of car 1. Group 3 will add body to chassis of car 2. Group 2 will add engine to chassis of car 3 and group 1 will prepare chassis of car 4. At time T4, group 5 will perform final checkup of car 1. Group 4 will paint body of car 2. Group 3 will add body to car 3. And group 2 will add engine to chassis of car 4. So here, after time T4, first car is delivered. And after that, at each clock cycle, a new car is delivered. So with pipelining, we can produce 4 cars by time T7. That means, pipelining increases the throughput of car manufacturing plant. And if you can observe carefully, then you can see the output of previous group becomes input of next group. Now let us apply the concept of pipelining in computer. Here, an instruction can be divided into 5 subtasks on the basis of operation they perform. That is, instruction fetch, instruction decode, operand fetch, instruction execution, and last, operand store. So initially, the instruction is fetched, it is then decoded, after that, operands of instruction are fetched, then the logical and arithmetic operations are performed on operands, and lastly, the result is stored on memory. After understanding the division of instruction, let us see how n number of instructions of a process are pipelined. Let's say we have 4 instructions and first instruction is completed in 5 clock cycles. As instruction is divided into 5 subtasks, it will require 5 clock cycles to complete execution. After 5th clock cycle, in every next cycle, execution of a new instruction is completed. With this way, the hardware of your system will never sit idle and will always keep on performing some or the other operation. Remember, the same stage of 2 different instructions will never be executed in same clock cycle. The pipelined processors can be classified depending on their functionality. First is arithmetic pipelining. It is designed to perform high-speed floating point operations. Here, multiple arithmetic logical units are built in system to perform parallel arithmetic computations on various data format. Next is instruction pipelining. Here, the number of instructions are pipelined and execution of current instruction is overlapped by the execution of subsequent instruction. It is also called as instruction look ahead. Next is processor pipelining. Here, the processors are pipelined to process same data stream. Thus, data stream processed by the first processor is reprocessed by the second processor, and the result of second processor is reprocessed by the third processor. Next is unifunction versus multifunction pipelining. The pipeline performing precise function every time is unifunctional, whereas the pipeline performing multiple functions at different time or multiple functions at same time is multifunctional. Next is static versus dynamic pipelining. The static pipelining perform a fixed function each time. Thus, it is also known as unifunctional. The static pipeline execute the same type of instructions continuously, and frequent change in type of instruction may vary its performance. However, dynamic pipeline performs several functions simultaneously. Thus, it is also known as multifunctional pipelining. Next is scalar versus vector pipelining. Scalar pipelining processes the instruction with scalar operands, whereas vector pipeline processes the instruction with vector operands. Now, sometime a pipeline has to stall or stop due to some reasons. This is called pipelining hazard. The first hazard is data dependency. Depending of one instruction on another for execution is called data dependency. In the example below, you can see that result of add instruction is stored in register R2 at clock cycle T4. But R2 is also an operand of next subtract instruction, whose operand fetch takes place in clock cycle T3. But as the correct value of R2 is available at T4, so subtract instruction needs to stall for 2 clock cycle. Thus, depending of one instruction on another for data is called data dependency. The next is memory delay. When an instruction or data is required, it is first searched in the cache memory, and if it is not found there, it is a cache miss. The data is further searched in the memory, which may take 10 or more clock cycles. So, for that number of cycle, pipeline has to stall, and this is called memory delay hazard. The cache miss also result in delay of all the subsequent instructions. The next hazard is branch delay. Suppose there are 4 instructions pipelined, I1, I2, I3 and I4 in a sequence. Now, the instruction I1 is a branch instruction and its target instruction is IK. The processing starts and instruction I1 is fetched, decoded and target address is computed at 4th stage in cycle T3. But till then, instruction I2, I3 and I4 are fetched in cycle 1, 2 and 3 before the target branch address is computed. As I1 is found to be a branch instruction, the instruction I2, I3 and I4 has to be discarded because the instruction IK has to be processed next to I1. So this delay of 3 cycles 1, 2 and 3 is branch delay. Prefetching the target branch address will reduce the branch delay. Like if target branch address is identified at decode stage, then branch delay will reduce to 1 clock cycle. The last hazard is resource limitation. If two instructions request for accessing same resources in same clock cycle, then one of the instruction has to stall and let other instruction to use the resource. This stalling is due to resource limitation. However, it can be prevented by adding more hardware. So this is how pipelining improves the throughput of your system and makes it more efficient. For more details, you can refer our official website binaryterms.com. I had given URL for the same in the description below. Please like and share this video with your friends and family, and don't forget to subscribe our YouTube channel About Technology. Keep checking the channel for further updates and put your comment and queries in the section below. We'll be back again soon with a new video. Till then, take a good care of yourself.